G'day guys, Tillis20 here and welcome back to Marble Mountain. Today we're going to be finally finishing off Port Montana. This is a port we've been working on for the last couple of weeks, so it's going to be good to be finishing it off. We're going to be doing some work on some industry that's going to be sitting in Arcadia, and also the bit of terraforming and just some general cleaning up of the area to really blend it into the rest of the environment. So if you want to see how everything turns out, then stick around to the end or skip to the end, however you want to do it. I've got some really nice cinematics lined up at the very end of the episode. And speaking of the end of the episode, I always leave this to the very end, but if you do enjoy this video, then leaving some feedback would be very much appreciated. It actually helps the video out a lot, helps me out a lot. So if you do enjoy this video, then let me know. Even if you just hit the like button, that'd be great. And if you haven't yet subscribed to the channel and you are enjoying the video, or if you enjoy my content, then hopefully you'll consider subscribing to the channel. I try to release twice a week, mostly once a week, but I'm usually doing a very similar format of chipping away at a city. I've got a couple going at the moment, and if you do subscribe, then let me know, because I always like to know if new people are joining in. So today we are working in a suburb, well, I guess a district called Arcadia. This is a district that is mostly going to be industrial. There are some elements of it across the other side of the highway that are suburban. That sort of area is a bit more rough, and it's probably not the nicest neighborhoods. And this area is mostly going to be industrial with some warehouses. And as you can see, I'm sort of trying to make everything look a little bit more dingy by putting down some piles of rubble and garbage and stuff like that. At the moment, this is probably the largest, this is the largest industrial park of Marble Mountain at this point. It probably will end up being the largest area, the most concentrated area of industry and warehouses, and probably where most of the export and imports happening. So we do have a pretty substantial train line and highway connection that is getting to this area, which does make it a lot easier to get a lot of that import and export happening. And it's a nice concentration of noise and pollution too. And this highway too, so this highway pretty much breaks up the industry and all the suburbs, so that we're not really getting too much of a blend. There's a good barrier between the two, so we're not getting much complaint from the neighborhoods, some of the suburbs that are right next to this area. Though there is like a little bit of industry that is creeping onto the other side, and I did want that because I did want some of these neighborhoods to be a bit more rough and a bit more of a ghetto. So some of those neighborhoods probably aren't the nicest areas of Marble Mountain, and it actually makes a really nice contrast because there are some nicer suburbs not too far away from this area. They sit up on the headland and they're also along the beachfront, so it's kind of cool to see that contrast between the two, and also what makes the difference, because I think these ones are like, these neighborhoods are so much closer to Arcadia, which is a bit more of a dingy suburb, mostly industry, and probably experience a bit of noise and pollution around this area. So there is a real mix going on, and I did want a mix. If I really wanted there to be a real clean break between the pollution and noise and the industry, I probably would keep the industry further away from some of the suburbs. Most of them are, but there is still that bit of a blend, which I think creates just a little bit more realism. So to create some of these warehouses, because I am using pretty much all vanilla assets, I wanted to make a couple more custom style warehouses. So what I'm doing here is I've actually placed together three of these vanilla warehouses, which are a bit smaller, and by connecting them all together and changing the color using a couple of mods, then you can create like a much larger warehouse. And I thought that this might be a cool spot for a storage unit. It was a bit tricky because there are these, I couldn't get rid of some of the lights, so some of the lights are poking through the roof, which really annoyed me, but I couldn't really avoid that. Ended up changing some of the positions of the lights, so I think only one of them ends up poking through the roof, but if you're feeling a little bit triggered from that, yeah, so am I, but I still think the result's worth it, so I decided just to keep it. also using some of the parking lot roads, which are so versatile. I actually had the pleasure of meeting the creator of those parking lot roads, which is Bad Idea. I got to meet him along with a lot of other asset and YouTubers and mod creators at PDXCon. That was only last week. This is actually my first video back, my first commentary back, and feel a little bit rusty, but also feeling really motivated and excited to get back into it because I was away for about 3 weeks and hadn't recorded anything or played the game for about 4 weeks. So feeling really excited to be back and working in Marble Mountain and also working a bit more in Sichuan province because I have just visited Chongqing. So I am feeling very inspired to be working there. But yeah, it was really cool to meet him, and he's actually done a lot of work with me to create some custom things for Sichuan province, which, yeah, massively grateful for. So it was really cool to meet him, really cool to meet a whole bunch of those guys, and look forward to doing it soon. Really looking forward to doing it soon. So this area, this is probably one of my favorite areas of this build, and there's this like little warehouse or I guess factory that I placed down on its own road. It's a bit more old school, it's made out of wood, and I'm pretty sure it's a forestry building. I always forget about those buildings. I generally stick with the generic industry buildings from the vanilla game, but this one I always forget about, but it's actually one of my favorite looking vanilla assets. So because it is one of my favorites, I thought I'd stick it in a spot that was a little bit more eye candy, right next to the railway line and not very many other buildings around it. It's probably a much more older style industry building. It was probably here much before the storage unit and a lot of the other industry that was here. I reckon it's probably abandoned now, but maybe it's still being used. I actually get a really strong GTA 5 feel to this building. It really reminds me of that kind of hidden industrial building that's close to Grove Street, around where the suburbs are, and you drive down this road and there's pretty much just like some silos there in this building, and I think there's a couple of missions there where you might get ambushed by some mobs or something like that, but I don't know, I was sort of going for that because it just sort of gave me that sort of feel, so decided to place it down in a similar location. I guess it's a little bit different, but I was definitely going for that in my brain. If you ever want to add to the story of this city, by the way, you can always jump onto the wiki. That we've got this amazing wiki that has all these backstories to some of these buildings and to the suburbs, and if you want to write something about Arcadia or even the port or some of the suburbs around this area, even if you want to write a story about that building I spoke about, you don't have to give it the same story that I just came up with. You can totally write your own description. You might even decides to be the owner of that building. It's totally up to you. I have no real control over that wiki. It's pretty much all fan made, and I want to keep it that way. And if you do end up adding to it, which would be awesome, don't forget to check out the how-to guide, because there is a really comprehensive, quite easy to follow how-to guide to adding to it. And also just be careful not to add any conflicting stories or stories that are overlapping, because we have had a couple of stories where two people or three people have written stories about the same area and they don't really fit together. So just make sure you get a bit of an idea of what everything's doing, like what people are talking about, and you know how it all fits together. It's pretty easy just to check out some of the other stories and what other people have been writing and adding to it. And I also think probably the best part about the wiki is the Discord chat, which is this Discord server where people are just chatting about different stories and things that they can add to the wiki as we build in each episode. So don't forget to check that out as well. I did really want to make this area blend into the rest of the suburbs, and was trying to think of how to get the highway to not look so extreme, because it is up on a much higher ledge than where the port is, because there is actually quite an extreme difference in height, particularly because the port is pretty much at sea level or just above, whereas the highway is actually quite high up. So making the transition between the two was quite tricky, and I decided to just create a bit of a barrier with a bit more foliage, a bit of trees, because I tend to go overboard with buildings and parks and always trying to fill in as much gaps as possible rather than just letting places just sit as nature. And now that we are getting a little bit further out of the city, I can sort of justify leaving some more places just to breathe and just to have some more areas for a bit more wildlife. So this is a bit of an area where I've just sort of made a couple of clusters. Clusters of trees is generally the best technique to create some realistic tree lines. And underneath, I'm just using some of the props, some of the vanilla prop bushes, and they work just so nice just to create a bit of undergrowth. I use them all the time. I even use them in my non-vanilla series, Sichuan Province. I still use these clusters all the time. Something that really made a nice difference and a really realistic difference is to drag this fence so that it was a barrier between the train line and this bush line too. And I also just use a bit of the ground textures to just paint down some of the gravel so that the gravel was all the way up to the fence line. And then you'll also see I do create a bit more of the tree line closer to the fence. Just creates this really nice barrier. It's such a simple technique, but it just adds so much to this area. Something I could do a fair bit of. That's actually something I learned from Strict Toast. He does it all the time and always makes such a huge difference. And it's really not much that I'm really changing here, and it just changes so much. So many of the things that I do that are like very simple and very easy, they always add the biggest difference. And then sometimes when I go overboard with detail, they tend to just clutter everything and, you know, chew up the FPS and not really create a smooth frame rate. So yeah, sometimes you're just gonna remember, keep it simple, and sometimes the simplest techniques are the most effective. And that's sort of kind of what this series is all about, is the simplest techniques. Again, I have actually spoken about this, but I am using vanilla containers to fill in some of these areas, and I do end up replacing them with Avanya's ones. I do would really love your opinion on this though. I would like to change, I'm considering changing a couple of the other assets that I placed down here. So the trucks don't really fit in anymore, so I think I might swap them out for a couple of trucks that are from the workshop. And I don't know, I am also considering grabbing a couple of custom assets. Let me know what you think, because I know that we are trying to go for fairly vanilla builds, and you know, we are trying to work with what the game gives us as much as possible, but I am tempted just to dive in and grab like maybe 15 or so custom assets just to create just that little extra realism. We have been doing this series for about a year now. Actually, we have been doing this series for a year now, and we've done a pretty good job at keeping fairly vanilla, but I would love your opinion. Would you be happy with me jumping on a couple of extra assets, or should I just keep doing what I am doing? Let me know. And I might even do a poll, to be honest. Let's do a poll. That's it, guys. We've finished with this episode. I hope you've enjoyed it. I've already mentioned it before, but if you have liked it, then leaving some feedback in the comment section or just rating up the video would be very helpful. So thanks for doing that if you have done it already. And if you're new here, and if you like subscribing, if you enjoyed what you've seen, then I hope you do, and let me know, because I do like to know when new people are joining in, and if you're getting inspired or feeling motivated from this build, then yeah, let me know. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!